I'm Maureen Sullivan from the Bedford Chamber of Commerce, and this is Chamber Connections. And today my guest is Joan Turnberg from Live Life Well, and we're going to be talking about massage. Wonderful thing. Joan, welcome.
Thank you for having me, Maureen.
You're welcome. So let's start out with, why don't you just give me a base opinion of what massage is?
What is massage? Well, massage is the manipulation of a muscle to induce relaxation and to reduce tension. And generally, there's an overall feeling of just being decompressed and less stressed.
And so how long have you been a massage therapist? Is that the correct term?
Massage therapist is the correct term, and I have been practicing massage since 1995.
And how did you get into that? Like, you know, I know you teach Nia, which we could talk about a little at the end. So is this just sort of a extension of Nia?
It's actually something totally different than Nia. I got into massage because I was working in the corporate world, and massage was just something totally different. So it was like corporate meets Zen. And I did a weekend workshop at the Muscular Therapy Institute where I did my training and loved it and applied and got in, and here I am. So while I was working full-time, I did massage therapy part-time.
And what's the best schooling? Is it a lot of schooling? How long did it take you to become a muscular therapist?
At the time that I was in school, it was a 1,200-hour program, which was a fairly extensive program. There was a lot more hands-on time dedicated.
Awesome. Yeah. So what type of people come to get massage? I think that massage is sort of something that now with sports injuries, people are a lot more open to it. Mm. Probably people that are older than us, than me, kind of look at it still a little bit leery. So do you have, all kinds of people coming for massage?
And I do. So I have people age range from their 20s to their 70s. And actually one time someone did bring her 100-year-old grandmother.
Nice.
Very cute. And why do people come? Great reason. You know, some people, I have a classic customer. She always comes when she injures herself. Mm-hmm. And usually it's her back. And so, I'll work to, eliminate the spasm she has. A lot of people come to be unplugged for the time that they're there. No one needs anything of them, and they don't have to do anything. So there's that. People will come for a one-hour treatment, an hour-and-a-half treatment, whatever works in their schedule. People do come for injuries and generally relaxation.
Well, I have to say I did come and have a massage by you because I had a sore neck. And yesterday I went to my trainer, and she said, "How's your neck?" And I'm like, it doesn't hurt. And I was trying to think back, and it was because, I did hurt the next day, which I knew I would. But after that, I was cured. So
excellent.
Thank you very much.
My pleasure.
So where do you do massage? Do you have an office?
Mm-hmm. I have a home office that I practice massage. People will have home offices. They also have, an office elsewhere, or there's other places like Massage Envy and things like that. So there's different venues for massage.
Now, do you go out and do massage, like in businesses? Or, like when they do chair massage or,
Yes, I have been to many wellness or benefits fair to do chair massage for the employees. Also, some companies, they'll offer chair massage for their staff just because it's a simple yet thing that expresses appreciation to their employees. And employees will love it.
I bet.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's talk a little bit about those things that you brought with you.
Okay.
Right there.
So not everyone can get a massage every day like Bob Hope did, and that's probably what...
Bob Hope had a massage every day?
Bob Hope had a massage every day.
Which not from his wife, someone else?
No, someone else.
He had a massage. What did he live to be, like 100?
It was something close to that, and I'm sure that helped for his longevity.
Sure.
So this is very simple. This is a tennis ball inside of a long sock, and what you do is you lap it over your shoulder and you press into the seat that you're in, and you just follow the pleasure principle on what feels good, and you have the end of it that you can guide it up or down. And I have this in my car. You can bring this on a plane with you. It's great for travel because you can go through TSA with it. And we sit so long in our where we're the places that we're going, that it's a nice way to just give the muscles some loving,
because
they've been...
I mean, it's not as good as your hands, but it could work in a pinch.
And, you know, for you moms out there, it's a great toy because I use this for me, and then it was a great distraction for when my son was much younger.
Right. And you told me before you came in that you brought a golf ball, but we seem to have rolled it away. So what is that
so
for?
So we'll pretend this is a golf ball. And I have two golf balls under my desk. Mm-hmm. And so with bare feet or sock feet, I will roll my feet over the golf ball. And it is just heaven. So I do that every day for those people that have plantar fasciitis. This is a nice thing to do to help massage the arch of the foot. If a golf ball is too intense, a tennis ball is a great place to start as well. So easy self-care techniques people can do for themselves.
Awesome. So let's talk a little bit about Nia, because I like that name, and I know you teach a class right across from my office. So tell me what that is.
Yeah. Nia is a fusion of dance, martial arts, and yoga. And I was introduced to it in 2004 when one of my employees she had me read this yoga article, and there was a sidebar about Nia. And I was like, wow, that sounds really cool. So I took a class in West Concord and loved it. And it was a time where my company was transitioning to California, so I was looking to do something different. So I have a martial arts background, and that's what drew me to it. Hmm. And each class is a little different. If your left is different than mine, it's fine. It's not about so much getting movement right, but it's about moving your body in a way that feels good.
Well, it's interesting because right before we came to tape this, you just taught a class, right?
I did, yes.
Saw that nice glow on your face. And a woman came into my office, and an older woman, and well, not that old, but she said that she loved the class because it moved every part of her body, but not in a bad way, which is, you know, I can't say I've taken a class. I always say I'm going to, and maybe one of these days I'll
open invitation
come across. But, you know, that's nice because, you know, you don't come out hurting.
No.
Which is awesome. And so you've done these two things, Nia and muscular therapy. So tell me, for sports injuries, like when people decide to come and get a massage for a specific injury, is that something ongoing? Like, you know, you have a bad back. Is it like a once a week thing? Is it, you know, you can get fixed and then you're off or what?
Ooh, great question and a hard question. You know, each person's body is different. Each injury is different. And, you know, I actually had someone come to me last week that was referred to me, and she was having shoulder issues, frozen shoulder. And that's what she had called it. And, you know, I worked on her, and her range of motion was enhanced. But she had more stuff going on.
Right.
She really needed to go see a physical therapist. So I referred her out to a physical therapist. So, you know, I'm really clear of working within the certain scope that I can work in, but there's some things that people do need to seek a physical therapist for.
So let's just talk a little bit about the Chamber of Commerce, because you are a member of the Chamber of Commerce. And how's that been for you? Like, have you got a lot of clients out of the Chamber?
I think being a member of the Chamber has been a worthwhile benefit. I have massage clients that are Chamber members. I have massage clients that aren't Chamber members but were referred to me by Chamber members, as well as people in my NIA class that are Chamber members.
That are Chamber members, yeah. We like to promote you.
And, you know, there's a nice camaraderie in the Chamber, and it's been wonderful to get to know folks.
Yeah, you've been with us
there
for quite a while, right?
Because
you started our, well, you didn't start it, but you did our Working Women Alliance for, what, 5 years?
For about 5 years,
yes,
yeah.
And you've just retired, which I'm very sad about that. But we have it going still. Not quite Joan-ish, but we're getting up there, so that's good. Well, listen, I again want to thank you for coming, and I loved my massage. As I told you, you said when you when I came to see you that your goal this year was to get 5 new clients, and I will say that I'm coming back.
Excellent, thank you.
Because my neck is unsore. And you can get Joan's information at the Chamber website, www.bedfordchamber.org, or I believe at the end of this program.
Great.
So thank you for coming.
You're so welcome, Maureen.